back to our stupid Rex Idiots. I'm Corbin.
I'm Rick, and if you thought that was loud in your headphones, you should have been here.
Ooh. And what's our names? Corbin and Rick.
Yeah, we just did that, man.
Did we?
We really did.
Wow.
You're losing your mind.
I've been not drinking enough.
Put some old monk in your coffee.
And you can follow us on Instagram and Twitter for more juicy content. And thank you for on Patreon and follow us on official Twitter account. And today, we are reacting to a video.
Shocking, I know.
Wait a minute. Everything we do on this is a video of some kind. We're watching videos of reactions, trailers, wow. Reviews. So
you're so smart.
This is a I'm assuming music video?
No.
It's
actually a military video. I haven't done one of those
wow,
in a while.
Wow, it's been a while.
It's been a while. So I wanted to find something. Somebody sent me this. It's actually the U.S. and India Special Forces training together.
That happens a lot, actually. We know about this.
So that's great.
We've
looked at
Special Ops?
It's just Special Forces is all it tells me. Oh, we can read this little synopsis for me.
Soldiers from 2 to 14 Cavalry and 2nd Brigade 25th Infantry Division from Hawaii trained with Indian Special Forces during Exercise Yudhabhyas in April 2012, Rajasthan, India. This annual exercise is made to build the relationships between the soldiers of the two nations and build mutual trust as well as train soldiers to be combat ready.
Awesome. We both have if you haven't been around long enough, we've done quite a few military videos, especially towards the beginning. But we have an affinity for the military of any country that's not a terrorist country.
Yeah. Who fights for truth, justice.
Yes. And so we enjoy these types of video. My father's military.
Yeah, and I have military. high regard for all military personnel, especially Navy SEALs and special operators. And
so here we go.
And we got ready in at speed at 20:30 from here.
U.S. and Indian forces receive intelligence that a terrorist leader is taking refuge in an insurgent camp in the Rajasthan desert. The mission calls for conventional forces to surround the camp and then calls special forces to extract the insurgent leader for questioning.
Exercise was basically order and search operation being carried out with the makeup component of the US and the Indian Armed Forces, and wherein there was a heavy volume of fire from one of the houses for which the SF intervention was asked for.
US and Indian conventional forces cordoned off and searched the town, house to house, receiving some heavy fire and casualties.
And after the search, they came to a place where they were at, where the bomb makers were, and they reached heavy fire.
The amount of preparation they go through.
So they called special forces in because we were on standby. They came down, slithered down.
Awesome.
Myself, I rolled in the ATV, pulled the inner cord on.
The U.S. soldiers and the Indian Special Forces maneuvered their way through the town. Once they identified the house where the insurgent was, they moved in.
Bravo 4, all stations, no more transmission, approaching target house.
The exercises and the training with the US forces are very nice experience for everybody.
This type of high intensity and realistic training helps build a long-lasting relationship between the soldiers from the two nations.
Absolutely terrific training. Indian soldier and U.S. soldier in buddy teams, working side by side, great partnership, great engagement, and I thought superior training.
The Great job. How's it?
Great work. You guys enjoy?
Yes, sir.
Mm. Cool. And there was a another video. I was hoping that was gonna be a little longer.
Yeah.
It was cool to see. I one of the things I love about the military is that obviously they're very prepared, but the extent they go to be prepared, like creating the models of the towns,
right,
and knowing exactly where you're gonna be stopping, you're gonna be going, and you're gonna be reporting back, and all that kind of stuff is literally like it takes them days, if not weeks, sometimes to plan out certain things, and they
right.
go over every single scenario,
right,
and all that kind of stuff. It's just so impressive to me the amount, and I love that it's the United States and India forces working together because we are allies, regardless of whatever's currently going on in the
yeah.
world.
Yeah,
I just love that. So
I do too. And I mean, we're not going to ever really see anything that gives away too much information about what the special operators. It's kind of like when, at least here in the United States, when you see the police and the SWAT come out and
yeah.
they're doing their strategies to get somebody out who's in a hostage situation or whatever it is, they will tell the media and the news cameras, do not give away what our tactics are.
Mm-hmm.
So there's only so much we're ever going to see. We're never going to see the full tactics. If you're ever really going to see the full tactics of something, you're going to see a movie way after the fact.
Yeah.
Not current tactics.
Zero Dark 30.
Yeah, exactly. You'll see it after it happened, because any of the tactics that are currently going on, they don't want people to know about that, especially
yeah.
the enemy.
Yeah.
In fact, it wouldn't surprise me if we've sometimes seen tactics that are made public that actually aren't the way they're going to be doing it.
Oh, no. No, no. I wouldn't allow that.
Yeah,
no,
I wouldn't allow it. Yeah, and I'm most interested in, as well, one of the things about special operators is that you... Like right now, as you're watching this video and we're talking, I guarantee there's some kind of a special operation going on somewhere with American forces, with Indian forces, either individually or in tandem, and the world won't even know it happened.
Mm-hmm.
It just occurred. They saved the world.
Yeah.
And no one will ever know.
No, not at all.
Yeah.
And obviously, American Indian forces are two of the... Obviously, now we know that India is, what, the second?
Massive.
Largest?
Yeah.
Army, correct?
Yeah, they went. I think they went from...
In terms of
total numbers of everything.
Yeah. And then obviously United States forces. So it's great to see us actually work together.
I just wish we could see that happening on a diplomatic level.
Yes. That would be preferable.
The military personnel have got a pretty clear cut in their mind what their objectives are and what they're doing, and they have no gray areas in their minds in regard to what it is
military,
we're doing.
Military, they're just, all right, we're both against
yeah.
an enemy.
Yep.
And we're working together.
We're working together.
But for some reason, the diplomatic sides are, for some reason, more complicated.
Yeah.
It shouldn't be, honestly. It's just...
yeah.
But that's a different subject for a different day.
And if you haven't seen them, for those of you who are new to the channel, we did a lot more of these back... at the
beginning. Yeah, we did some Indian Special Forces training, which is awesome.
Yeah, we did the Republic Day Parade.
Which will be coming up soonish,
again. Well, because when we started...
The end of the year, probably.
Right after Gully Boy, it was coming right up on the parade.
Yeah.
And we saw the footage of that for the first time, and
mm-hmm.
that's when we started doing some of the more military
and if there's
Special
more,
Forces videos.
Really awesome Indian Special Forces, any branch of the military. I don't know how many branches y'all have. Do y'all have the same...
Yeah, that's a good question.
How many branches do you have? You have probably the Army, the Air Force, the Navy, I would assume.
Right.
I don't know if you have a Coast Guard.
Right.
You can let me know.
I mean, I would imagine they do. They have they have coasts to guard.
That's true.
But that may be done by their Navy.
Navy.
Yeah.
I'd be interested to know.
And do you have songs for each of your branches of the military? Because we do here. Everybody here, whenever they do something for with the military branch, each of the branches has their own song. Their own insignia.
Yeah.
It's the military of the United States, but they're very proud. If you're Air Force, if you're Navy, if you're Coast Guard, if you're Army, if you're Marines, different looks, different things that you do in tandem.
I actually saw a video somebody sent me on Twitter. It was a little like 1 minute video, and I think it was another one of these things where they were doing a training thing together.
Yeah.
But the American Army was playing the Indian National Anthem.
Oh, nice.
And so it was really cool.
And I'd really like to see, there's some documentaries that have been done. For example, there's a couple of good documentaries about BUDS training for Navy SEALs, where for the first time they let somebody come in and show you some of what the the guys in Bud's training go through. I would love to see legit hardcore documentary stuff of some of the special operators' basic training. I'd love any of the branches of the military's training, but if it was the special operators that are comparable to the Navy SEALs or the Green Berets, I would love to see what India. We saw one that was like that, but I would really like to get like from a documentary that's been shot and shows you the real nuances of what they go through. Because it's,
I'm not sure
the respect level is off the charts for me.
Yeah, I don't know how many there actually are because they're not going to let you.
Right, no. No, like the one they did for the Navy SEALs, it was done with the permission of the Navy and with the, and they only showed you the stuff that current Navy SEALs are writing books about and sharing, because a lot of it, they're not going to share with you.
Of course. And then, or they should they.
Especially when it comes to the tactics. They'll show you what they do for the mental toughness and what they do to try to break them as far as the physical regimen, and it's primarily the mental regimen. But when they start doing battle tactics and they put them in actual war scenarios, you're never going to see that.
Yeah.
Well, that was, yeah, enjoyed that. Let us know if there's other military videos. We love these types of videos. So
and movies. I was just yesterday I was thinking, if I'm not mistaken, Uri should be available on streaming and be able to watch that, and I can show that to Micah.
Oh, it's definitely... it's
gotta be now.
I think it's on Amazon or something.
Yeah, because Micah's gonna love that. He didn't get to see that.
Yeah, so. And that's one of our favorite movies.
Yeah, if you haven't seen Uri...
Or URI.
Yeah. We did that. When we went to go see it, we show up to the movie theater, and the lady, I ask for URI, and she goes, oh, you want Uri? And I corrected her and said, no, URI.
We're a smartin'.
Uh-huh.